Page number 10.11, illustration number 5. Suresh does not maintain his books of accounts under double entry system, but keeps slips of paper from which he makes up his annual accounts. Suresh is not maintaining any books of accounts under double entry system, but he puts small chitties, slips of papers, from which he makes up his final accounts. He has borrowed monies from a bank to whom he has to render figures of profits every year. So he has taken a loan from a bank and he has to submit the profits of every year to the bank, the figures of profits every year to the bank. He has given to the bank the following profit figures. So he has given the following profit figures to the bank: 2008, 20,000 rupees. 2009, 32,000 rupees. 2010, 35,000 rupees. 2011, 48,000 rupees. And 2012, 55,000 rupees. The profit figures submitted to the bank are given to you. Next, the bank appoints you to audit the statements and verify whether the figures of profits reported is correct or not. The bank has appointed you as the auditor, and now you have to verify the profit figure submitted by Mr. Suresh, and you have to inform the bank whether the profit figures reported are correct or not. That is your job. For this purpose, the following figures are made available to you. So you are given some information by Mr. Suresh. A. Position on 31st December 2007. Sundry debtors 20,000. Stock in trade at 95% of the cost, 47,500. Stock is not shown at cost, stock is shown below cost, at 95%. Cash in hand and cash at bank, 12,600. Trade creditors, 6,000. Expenses due, 1,600. B. Mr. Suresh had borrowed rupees 5,000 from his wife on 30th September 2007, on which he had agreed to pay a simple interest at 12% per annum. So on 30th September 2007, Mr. Suresh has borrowed a loan of rupees 5,000 from his wife, on which he has agreed to pay a simple interest at the rate of 12% per annum. Next, the loan was repaid along with interest on 31st December 2009. So Mr. Suresh repaid the loan along with interest on 31st December 2009. In December 2008, he had advanced rupees 8,000 to Mr. A for purchase of vacant land. Mr. Suresh has given 8,000 rupees to Mr. A for purchase of a vacant land. Settle down quickly. The property was registered in March 2010 after payment of the balance consideration of rupees 32,000. So in 2008, Mr. A advanced 8,000 rupees, Suresh advanced 8,000 to Mr. A, and he also paid 32,000 rupees in March 2010, and he got the land registered by incurring registration costs of 7,500. Okay. Next, Suresh purchased jewellery for rupees 15,000 for his daughter in October 2010. Suresh purchased some jewellery for his daughter in October 2010. Marriage expense incurred in January were 24,000 rupees. So please tell me, purchase of jewellery for daughter, what is it? A business asset or a drawing?
Drawing.
Okay. And expenses incurred for marriage of daughter?
Drawing.
Again, it is definitely drawing. E. A new VCR was purchased by him, by Suresh, in March 2012 for 18,000 and presented by him to his friend in November 2012. What is it? Purchase of a VCR. Now we don't have VCRs, we have no CD players, DVD players, Blu-ray players. So we'll assume it is a CD player which we have purchased for our friend and we have gifted it to him. So what is it? Is it a business asset or a drawing?
Drawing.
F. His annual household expenses amounted to a minimum of 24,000 rupees. His household annual expenses amounted to a minimum of 24,000 rupees. Its personal expenses, drawings. G. The position of assets and liabilities as on 31st December 2012 was found to be overdraft with bank, secured against property 12,000, trade creditors rupees 10,000, expenses payable 600, sundry debtors including 600 due from a peon declared insolvent by the court 28,800, stock in trade at 125% of cost to reflect market value rupees 60,000 and cash in hand rupees 250. It is found that the rate of profit has been uniform throughout the period and proportion of sales during the year to total sales for the period was in the ratio of 3:4:4:6:8. Ascertain the annual profits and indicate the difference, if any, with those reported by Suresh to the bank earlier. All workings are to form part of your answer. So now please tell me, how many years profit Mr. Suresh has submitted to the bank? He has submitted profits of 2008, 2009, 2010, 2011 and 2012. Okay, so now the bank has appointed us as a chartered accountant to audit, verify the figures reported by Suresh and to give the information to the bank whether the profits reported are correct or not. Okay, I think in our last class we learned a method, profit determination by comparing capital. So what is capital comparison method of profit determination? We said compare adjusted closing capital with opening capital. Compare adjusted closing capital with opening capital. If adjusted closing capital is more than opening capital, then you have profit. If adjusted closing capital is lower than opening capital, then there is a loss. Yes? So how do you calculate adjusted closing capital? We take closing capital figure, we add back drawing, we add back interest on drawing, we subtract other capital, we subtract interest on capital, we subtract salary, remuneration, etc. to arrive at adjusted closing capital. Then we compare it with opening capital. Now to apply this method, first of all we require opening capital figure and we require closing capital figure. How do you calculate opening capital and closing capital? Yesterday we learned that opening capital, you will prepare a statement of affairs on the opening date, list down the asset, list down the liabilities due to outsiders, you will get the capital as balancing figure. Similarly, on the closing date, prepare a statement of affairs, list down the assets, list down the liabilities, and the balancing figure will be capital. Compare adjusted closing capital with opening capital to arrive at profit. Now if you observe the problem, you are given information about assets and liabilities as on 31st December 2007 and you are also given information about assets and liabilities as on 31st December 2012. Where is it given? See, point number A in the problem. Position as on 31st December 2007. Data, stock in trade, cash in hand, trade creditors, expenses due. And some information is given regarding loan taken by Suresh from his wife, which was repaid along with interest in 2009. So you are given some information relating to assets and liabilities as on 31st December 2007. Similarly, point number G, you are given the position as on 31st December 2012. Yes? So now, using point number A and point number G, first of all, we have to calculate the capital balance as on 31st December 2007, which will become opening capital, and arrive at capital balance as on 31st December 2012, which will be closing capital. And in between these dates, 31st December 7 and 31st December 12, what all drawings, capital reduction has taken place is already given to you in the problem, which will help us to calculate the profits. So let us start with preparation of statement of affairs as on 31st December 2007. Statement of affairs of Mr. Suresh as on 31st December 2007. Liabilities rupees, assets, rupees. So this statement of affairs is prepared only on 31st December 2007. Then we'll prepare a similar statement as on 31st December 2012. Position as on 31st December 2007. Sundry debtors 20,000. Is it after any bad debts? The answer is no. Sundry debtors is 20,000. Sundry debtors 20,000. Stock. What is the value of stock given to you in the problem? Stock in trade at 95% of cost, 47,500. We don't know why the value of stock was reduced. Hence, we have to show stock at cost only, normally in the balance sheet. Unless the problem clearly says the NRV of the stock was below the cost, then we can write off the value. Yes, so we have to calculate the profits. Hence, we are going to show stock at cost. 47,500 divided by 95%. 50,000. Now, listen to me carefully. Suppose you will show stock at 47,500, you will get capital balance after reduction in value of stock. Are you able to understand? And normally, whenever we report information to the bank, we submit the cost price of the stock to the bank. See, bank will give you overdraft facility, cash credit facility based on your stock figures, based on your debtors figure. If you want more and more borrowing from the bank, you have to report higher values to the bank. Hence, normally stock will be shown at cost to the bank. Okay. Stock 50,000 rupees. Next, cash in hand, cash at bank. Cash in hand and at bank. How much? 6,000. Expenses due 1,600 expenses due. Yes. Now read point number B. Mr. Suresh had borrowed 5,000 from his wife on 30th September 2007. So before this date, we are preparing the statement of affairs on which date? 31st December 2007. So 3 months before this date, Mr. Suresh approached his wife and he has borrowed how much from his wife? 5,000. On which he had agreed to pay. On which he had agreed to pay, he has not paid yet. Agreed to pay simple interest at the rate of 12% per annum. The loan was repaid along with interest only on 31st December 2009. So he has gone to his wife, he has borrowed 5,000 rupees and he has promised to pay interest, and the entire principal amount along with interest was repaid only on 31st December 2009. My question is, on 31st December 2007, loan from wife, was it outstanding or not as on this date?
Yes.
Was the loan outstanding on this date?
Yes.
And how many months interest was outstanding?
Yes.
He did not pay interest, entire interest, and the entire principal was repaid only in 2009. Loan from wife, inner column 5,000 plus accrued interest 5,000 into what is the rate of interest? Now what will you get? You will get capital as balancing figure. Total capital. This is the opening capital. Now we have to prepare a similar statement as on 31st December 2012 to arrive at the closing capital figure. Statement of affairs as on 31st December 2012. Liabilities, rupees. Assets, rupees. Now read point number G. The position of assets and liabilities as on 31st December 2012 was found to be overdraft with bank secured against property 12,000. Bank overdraft 12,000 rupees. Next. Trade creditors 10,000. Trade creditors 10,000. Outstanding expenses. Some expenses are also payable, I think. Expenses payable 600 rupees. Expenses payable 600 rupees. Sundry debtors, including 600 due from a pune, declared insolvent by the court, 28,800. Show the entire debtors amount. Debtors, 28,800. If you show debtors after bad debts, you will get profits after bad debts. Let us first of all calculate the total profits, then we can subtract bad debts, and then we can show profits after bad debts. If you show debtors here after bad debts, the profit which you determine will be after considering those bad debts. So let us initially first of all calculate what were the total profits. Then we can remove bad debts. That will give us the actual profits on. Is it clear? So I am showing gross debtors. 28,800. Yes. Alternative ways you can deduct it and show the net figure also. No problem. Stock in trade at 125% of the cost to reflect market value 60,000. Please tell me, stock should be normally shown at what value in your balance sheet? Cost. But the value given to you is not at cost, it is at 125% of cost to show the market value. Please tell me, accounting standard 2 tells us that stock should be valued at cost or NRV, whichever is lower. When information about NRV is not given, you have to show stock at cost. What is the problem doing in this problem? What is the information given to you? Stock is 60,000. It is 125% of cost to show market value in the balance sheet. We are not going to show market values in the balance sheet. Stock at cost. How much will it be? It will be 48,000. How? 60,000. Divide by 125 into 100. If cost is equal to 100, market value is equal to 125, 125 was equal to 60,000. So what is 100 equal to? That is what we have done. If cost is 100, market value is 125. 125 is equal to 60,000. What is 100 equal to? What is 100 equal to now? 48,000. Next, cash in hand 250 rupees. What about loan from wife? Is it still outstanding on 31st December 2012?
No.
See point number D. The loan was repaid along with interest on 31st December 2009 itself. So as on 31st December 2012, that loan is not outstanding. It has been cleared. Hence it is not going to come in the closing balance sheet. Is it clear? Now, read point number C also. In December 2008, Suresh had advanced 8,000 rupees to Mr. A for purchase of a vacant land. The property was registered in March 2010. After the payment of balance consideration of 32,000, costs of registration incurred for this were 7,500. So please tell me, what was the total amount spent on land? 8,000 plus 32,000 plus 7,500. 47,500. I am assuming it is a personal land which Mr. Suresh has purchased. I will treat 47,500 rupees as drawings of Mr. Suresh. Now, sir, if I show it in a balance sheet, will my problem go wrong? The answer is no, boss. Alternative treatment possible. If you show land in the closing balance sheet, even then your answer will be right. Either you are going to show land as a business asset or you show land as a drawing. Show 47,500 rupees as a drawing. Any treatment you follow, the answer will be correct. Now, what I am going to do is, I am going to assume 47,500 was drawn by Mr. Suresh for his personal purpose. He purchased land for his personal purpose. Is it clear? Are you able to understand? Or if you show it as a business asset also, you can show it in the balance sheet. Both the answers you will get will be one and the same only. Now, at home, check if you put land in the balance sheet as a business asset. Then whether you get the same answer or not, do it at home, not here, okay? So, I am assuming the amount spent on land as a drawing. Now you can calculate capital as the closing balance.
54.
How much?
54.
Total. Point number G, the problem is not talking about the existence of land also. We don't know what happened to the land also. Hence, it is better we treat it as an drawing itself. Is it clear? So now we have both the closing capital figure, we have now the opening capital figure. Now we have to determine profit for the period of 5 years. Let us start now. You know this, right? Calculation of profits. Calculation of profits. You can write the heading like this. Calculation of adjusted closing capital and profits. Particulars. Rupees. Two column table. Now please tell me, how do you calculate adjusted closing capital?
Closing capital
add drawing. You don't have interest on drawing, interest on capital. Add drawing less further capital. You will get adjusted closing capital. You don't have salary appreciation commission also in this problem because it's a proprietary concern which we are talking about.
Closing capital.
54,450 add drawings
underline. For purchase of land, 47,500 totally, 8,000 advance, 32,000 on registration, 7,500 for registration expenses. Point number B, not point number B, point number C, 8,000 plus 32,000 plus 7,500, 47,500. Then purchase of jewelry for daughter and marriage expenses of daughter. Jewelry and marriage expenses of daughter. How much? 39,000. Total? What was the jewelry purchased? Value 15,000 plus 24,000, it is 39,000. Next, point number E, VCR purchased for a friend. VCR purchased and gifted. How much?
80,000.
VCR purchased and gifted. Yes, just shift now. Why are you wasting time? VCR purchased and gifted to his friend 18,000. And his annual household expense amounted to a minimum of 24,000. Household expenses. 24,000 into 5 years. Each year 24,000. 2008, 9, 10, 11, and 12. 5 years. How much is it? 1,20,000. Do you have any further capital introduced? Tell me in the problem. There is no further capital introduced. Adjusted closing capital. Adjusted closing capital. 2,78,950 rupees. Now after this, we compare adjusted closing capital with what? Opening capital. Less opening capital. How much? 69,850. You get profit before bad debts. Profit before bad debts. You remember, here we have shown debtors before allowing bad debts, before subtracting bad debts. Hence the profit which you get will be profits before bad debts. How much? 2,09,100 is your profit before bad debts. Less bad debts. How much? 600 rupees. Profits for 5 years. Profits for 5 years is 2,08,500. Now listen to me carefully everyone. Instead of showing expenses incurred on land as a drawing, if I show it as an asset, what will happen? The closing capital balance will automatically increase. If I show it as an asset in the business books of accounts, then I cannot show it as a drawing. But both the effects will be the same. If I include land here, automatically closing capital will be higher by 47,000 because it is arrived at as a balancing figure. Total of the asset will not be 77,000 now. It will be 77,050 plus 47,500. Automatically capital balance will also be more by 47,500. And then when we are solving the problem, we cannot show purchase of land as a drawing. Here also we have added it to 54,450, no? If you show land here, automatically get added here. Everybody understand? So any effect you show, it is going to be the same. now. This is the total profit for 5 years. How the profits were distributed over those 5 years, see point number, last paragraph. It is found that rate of profit has been uniform throughout the period, and the proportion of sales during the year to total sales for the period was in the ratio of 3:4:4:6:8. So gross profit percentage on sales was the same every year. You are given the ratio of sales of all the years. Now these profits have to be apportioned in the ratio of 3:4:4:6:8, and then compare those profits with the profits reported to the bank. Okay, so now let us prepare a table, write down statement showing comparison of profits earned and profits reported. Can I rub this? Or else I'll rub this. Statement comparing actual profits with profits reported. Year, actual profits, profits reported, difference. Year 2008, 2009, 2010, 2011, and 2012. Look at the board. Profits reported are given to you. Give me the figures. Profits reported to the bank. Profits reported to bank. 20,000, 32,000, 48,000. Total 1 lakh. These were the profits reported to bank. 20, 32, 35, 48, and 55. Actual profits earned, just now we have found it, 2,08,500. Actual profits earned. Now share it in the ratio of, what is the ratio given? 3:4:4:6:8. Please share this in this ratio. 50,040. Find the difference. 5,020 short. Short reported. 1,360 short. $1,640 excess. 2,040 short. 11,720 short. Short reported. Short reported. Excess reported. Short reported and again short reported. Give me the difference.
18,500.
Short.